Atlanta United Fan TV 1-0 win. Orlando still has got nothing on us. And doesn't it feel quite good?
Yeah, they still have not won 2019. We'll talk more about that later this season. But yeah, 1-0 got a bit nervy at the end, but great to see Petey get off the mark. I mean, the only real criticism is this team needs to score more goals when they get the chances. The offside call was fair. It was right. It was really, really tight, unlucky. Tito was stoked when he had that assist too, which stinks. But, I mean, really that's the only thing you criticize is the lack of finishing. But Petey Martinez had a hell of a goal in 1-0. And aside from a couple of chances in the first half where Brad Guzan made some really good saves, and in the second where Miles Robinson had to make one hell of a block, Orlando didn't do too much. So, you know, controlled the ball, controlled the game. Wish we could have got more goals, but still, 3 points is 3 points. 4 wins in a row, 4 clean sheets in a row, 5 wins out of 6, and 5 clean sheets in all of those wins. So, as far as I'm concerned, that's progress in a good way.
Yeah. Now, in terms of, Tito and just his industry that he's bringing, the creativity, he arguably could have had 2 assists today. Nagby, unheralded. I mean, kind of a guy.
Nagby's incredible. I mean, the way that he can pick up the ball and turn on people in midfield, or fake one way, then go the other and leave two guys standing there going, where did he just go? I mean, he's playing incredible. He's playing like a DP midfielder, and we don't have the money for that, which is interesting because next season it's like you got to find some creative way to keep that guy around because he's playing some incredible stuff. This team seems more and more at ease with what they're trying to do. I think it was really fun to see the fact that the front three, well, specifically Joseph, PT, and Tito were really interchanging. And Joseph would go out to the left, PT would go up top, Tito would drop at the 10, and they'd all move around. And that was good to see. I love that fluid movement in the front. It makes it really difficult to defend. And then at the back, how guys will just slide into position for each other when they step up. If LGP goes forward, Rometty will drop back. Or if, you know, Parkhurst has to drop in at center back, it doesn't matter. The guys are rotating. Total football. They're playing how the Dutch would play, where if one guy goes, another person replaces their position. And it seems like they're finally understanding what Frank de Boer wants. And again, yeah, 1-0. You wish more for more goals, but a win's a win. 3 points is 3 points. And improvement, heading the right direction.
Right. Miles Robinson, I mean,
a unit.
Just an absolute unit. But, I mean, at one point, like, he just, like, stopped completely any sort of attack when they had a counter on.
I mean, every time they ran at Miles Robinson, he was just like, he pulled a Gandalf and said, you shall not pass, straight up. I mean, the dude has developed, and he continues to get better every single game. At the beginning of the season, you know, the question was, he has the athleticism, will he be good enough on the ball? Yes, he is very good on the ball. If he keeps playing like this, he might not be in America playing football in a couple of years' time because he has the raw athleticism, and now he's showing his talent, his technical ability as well. That's the type of player that teams in Europe will want. Yeah. And, I mean, we had two of our players that got drafted in the first round of that initial draft. One of them we got because Orlando let us have that pick, and both of them today were absolutely outstanding. But, I mean, to have two guys like that, the way this team's coming together, again, I still think we need a left back, but I hate that guy. At least he's farther away. We still need a left back, I think. But aside from that, this team's really doing great stuff, and they're heading in the right direction. 3 wins out of 3 in this month, which we thought was going to be critical. Hopefully they can keep that going. Got a midweek game, then Red Bull, then another midweek game. It's tough, but if they can keep picking up 3 points, then they're going to be heading in the right direction, and they'll be in first place come into the month.
How big of a miss was Nani in their side, and could they have eked it out if he had actually been in?
I definitely think Nani would have made a difference. He could have taken some of the chances that fell to some of their other players that maybe, you know, if he gets them, he will bury them. So it was good to see that he didn't make the trip. That's a nice relief to have. I think he would have made a difference, but he didn't play today, and Atlanta United still got the job done, and that's what matters.
How much rotation do you think is going to happen? You don't have to get into specifics, but, I mean, it looks like, yeah, some of the guys were pretty jaded today.
I think he has to. I mean, I don't see how you start Tito. I think Miram getting on the field was a good thing to see. He looked bright in the few minutes he was on. I think Miram will probably start. I can see Dion Pereira getting a start. There's no way Rometty starts. You had to start Larinowicz. But the problem is you have to pick between him and Nagby, and it's probably going to be Nagby that starts alongside Larinowicz because you don't have the depth in midfield. Unless there's some way that Gressel's fit enough that you could slide him in there. But, you know, it stinks you have to rotate so much because this team's playing so well together right now, and rotating can sometimes knock you off your stride. But it's going to be one of those things you just have to do. You have to do it. And that team did look leggy at the end. So we'll see what he does. It's going to be a tough game, but hopefully they can go get 3 more points and keep this run going.